Regarding, I'm coming to you, my sister. Coming to you.
Thank you, Chair. This is not the Attorney General. It's the Attorney General Emeritus.
Emeritus, yes.
And Senator number one in this Senate. I agree with the sentiments expressed by my colleagues on this issue. I will not repeat them. But the issue that we are discussing, the issue that we want to have a dialogue, constructive dialogue, with the two cabinet ministers is very, very important. I don't need to remind all of you that those who have observed the goings on in the world, troubles normally begin in a country when the issues of petroleum subsidies are changed and things go up. Because once that happens, then everything else is affected very adversely. And one of the platforms of Jubilee was that they would lower the costs of the petroleum and fuels and so on by the time, so that they can enable India to take off and the cost of living to come down and so on. But instead of doing that, it has now gone up. So we need a dialogue with the cabinet to find out why has that happened? What is the cause of it? Because it is only in addressing fundamentally the issues involved that you can find a fundamental solution, and not just to have an artificial solution that go and amend the act. Amend what? In what form and what not? The issue we are dealing with is also the issue of cabinet responsibility. Yes. I do not need to remind you that only about 2 weeks ago, there was a major reshuffle in the cabinet of the United Kingdom. And what was it caused by? It was caused by, partly, the Minister of Foreign Affairs of UK going on a holiday at a time when their soldiers were in Afghanistan, and a decision had been made that they should come back home. And instead of cancelling his holiday and saying a mass return home to ensure the safety of the British soldiers in the Afghanistan, he did not. That cost him a place as a Minister for Foreign Affairs. Now we are telling those who are out of the country now that this issue is so important that when you hear that you want to discuss it, when you hear the entire house is crying and they want to discuss it, fly back home and appear before the Senate committee so that you can get a solution to this problem. In fact, ordinarily, the cabinet could have done it quickly and immediately, because we know how the country is, the outcry outside there in the country. Ordinarily, they should have solved this problem by now. But the Senate and Parliament is now saying, come, we discuss. And they should be the first to come here and discuss the matter. Mr. Chairman, when we issue summons, the summons enjoy the status of a high court, of a court. And if a court issues a summons, you cannot go and write back a letter to say, sorry, these are wrong summons, they came to the wrong person, it should have been so and so, and not me. You go there and explain. The ministers ought to have come here and explained that they are not responsible. But the